story about how exactly Mary was found to be with child and how Joseph found out. There's a story there, and an untold story that makes me wonder. I wonder how Mary broke the news. I wonder how the news broke Joseph. It had to have, right? It had to have left him at least a little broken. I consider what Joseph knows up to this point. He knows that Mary is his fiancée, his betrothed, practically his wife. He knows that she is pregnant, and he knows that the child is not his. It is devastatingly simple. I mean, sure, maybe Mary told him the whole story about the angel's visit and the child being from the Holy Spirit, but would you have found that so easy to believe? Would you have bought that story? I don't think we can blame Joseph for needing some outside secondary confirmation. And that confirmation comes from an angel. It comes from an angel who appears to Joseph in a dream, saying, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid. Not be afraid." Over and over in the stories of this Advent season, angels appear and speak those very words, "Do not be afraid." And all throughout Advent, we'll be reading those stories, those words, those angelic admonitions, "Do not be afraid." We'll be discovering what those words might mean for our lives, for our fears today. "Do not be afraid," the angel said to Zechariah in the temple. "Do not be afraid," the angel says to Mary in Nazareth. "Do not be afraid," the angel says to those shepherds in the fields abiding. "And do not be afraid," the angel says to Joseph in a dream. In the Gospel of Matthew, we heard an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." "Do not be afraid," the angel says to Joseph in the midst of a REM cycle. And a piece of me feels like the angel has kind of misread the situation. "Do not be afraid." Afraid? I imagine Joseph is feeling a little bit more betrayed than afraid, right? I mean, afraid, is that the primary emotion you feel when you discover that your fiance is pregnant with a child that isn't yours? Afraid? I'd expect the angel to say something like, "Do not be angry, Joseph. Mary has been faithful to you." Or, "Do not feel betrayed, Joseph. You don't know the whole story." Or, "Do not be devastated, Joseph, because this bad news is actually the best news." But our dream sequence angel doesn't say any of that. Our dream sequence angel doesn't address Joseph's anger or betrayal or devastation. Instead, the angel joins with this angelic Advent chorus saying, "Do not be afraid." And maybe we shouldn't read too much into those words. "Do not be afraid." Angels are always saying that, right? "Do not be afraid." Angels are always saying that, probably because seeing an angel is in itself a terrifying experience, even if you're only seeing that angel in a dream. So maybe we shouldn't dwell too much on the angel's words. Or maybe we should. Hear the angel's words again. "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit." You know, there's something different about this particular angelic message compared with all the others. I mean, to Zechariah, the angel says, "Do not be afraid, for your prayer has been heard." And to Mary, the angel says, "Do not be afraid, for you have found favor with God." And to the shepherds, the angel says, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy." And to hear the form of the message is always the same. "Do not be afraid, for some incredible God stuff is happening." But this message to Joseph is different. "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife. Do not be afraid to. Do not be afraid to do something you are planning to do. Do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife." As one interpreter writes, the divine message is, in effect, "Do not hesitate. Take Mary as your wife." That's a compelling way to read the story. Do not hesitate to take Mary as your wife. Do not refrain from taking Mary as your wife. See, this is why we dwell on the angel's choice of words, because that's where we find the good stuff. Imagine if we were to read it as, "Do not let your fear stop you from taking Mary as your wife. Do not let your fear stop you." If we read the angel's words that way, then this angelic admonition is less about how Joseph feels and more about how Joseph should act in response to how he feels. It's more about how Joseph should act in the midst of his anger and betrayal and devastation, how Joseph should act in response to his fear. Do not let your fear stop you. Do not let your fear stop you. Outreach. You know, fear stops us from doing all kinds of things, and often that's a really good thing, right? A healthy fear of illness and injury keeps us from doing harmful or dangerous things. A reasonable fear of failure or financial ruin keeps us from doing foolish or irresponsible things. Fear in proper doses keeps us healthy and safe and stable and alive. A little fear can be a good thing. The problem is not when fear stops us from doing harmful or foolish things. The problem is when fear stops us from doing good and life-giving things. The problem is when fear stops us from doing the things that God wants us to do and living the lives God intends for us to live. Now, when we study the scripture, we're reminded that God gave us a spirit not of fear, but of power and love and self-control. Fear is not the fullness of God's intention for us. Fear is not the spirit that God has given us. So I wonder in this season of Advent, is fear stopping you from doing good and life-giving things? Is fear stopping you from doing the things God wants you to do? Is fear stopping you from living the life God intends for you to live? You need a visit from an angel. And if Joseph's angel were to appear to you right now, might that angel say, do not be afraid, do not hesitate to... Well, you would finish that sentence. Is fear stopping you from reconciling with someone with whom you've been estranged, from reaching out to someone against whom you've been holding a grudge? I mean, maybe you've wanted to resolve it, you've longed to reach out and reconcile, but something is causing you to hesitate. Is it fear that's stopping you? The fear that someone might still reject you? The fear that someone might more and disappoint you? And perhaps Joseph's angel would say, do not be afraid to take the first step. Do not let your fear stop you. Or is fear stopping you from stepping into a new path, a new opportunity, a new ministry that will take you out of your comfort zone? And maybe you felt called to it, and you know deep down it's something that God wants from you and for you, but something is causing you to hesitate. Is it fear that's stopping you? The fear that you won't be up to that challenge, the fear that you don't have the gifts to meet that need, the fear that you might end up in a situation that you don't know how to handle. Perhaps Joseph's angel would say, do not be afraid to try the new thing. Do not let your fear stop you. Or is fear stopping you from sharing your witness, your testimony, your faith with somebody who hasn't experienced the transforming love of Christ? And maybe you felt like there's an opportunity, that the opening is like right there, but something is causing you to hesitate. Is it fear that's stopping you? The fear that you won't be able to come up with the right words, the fear that the other person will ask a question you can't answer or make an argument you can't counter, the fear that you'll end up just looking naive and ridiculous. Perhaps Joseph's angel would say, do not be afraid to share this great love. Do not let your fear stop you. Or is fear stopping you from speaking up for justice? And maybe you've glimpsed some injustice in the world, and you know in the truest part of yourself that the way things are is not the way things should be, and that God and God's people have something to say about that. Something is causing you to remain silent. Fear that's stopping you? The fear your words will be met with indifference and inertia, or worse, that your words will be met with resistance or repercussion, retaliation. Perhaps Joseph's angel would say to you, do not be afraid to stand in the truth. Do not let your fear stop you. Do not let your fear stop you. And in fact, that's what the angel is saying to Joseph. And while we're certainly not in Joseph's situation, I think the angel's words can speak to us too. Do not be afraid. Do not hesitate. Do not refrain. Do not let your fear stop you. Do not let your fear stop you from doing what God has called you to do. Do not let your fear stop you from living the life that God has called you to live. Do not let your fear stop you from living as God intends you. Now this week, the first installment of our church-wide Advent study drew us into the world of Home Alone. Have you seen the movie Home Alone? Mm-hmm. If you haven't, it's on TV basically every night between now and Christmas Eve. Or you can join us for dinner and a movie next Sunday and see it then. Yeah, Home Alone, it tells the story of 8-year-old Kevin McAllister. You might remember, right, whose family accidentally leaves him home alone when they jet off to Paris for the Christmas holidays. Oops. And mostly the storyline involves Kevin defending his home against bumbling burglars Marv and Harry, but there's this tender B-plot scene near the end of the movie, a tender moment of connection between Kevin and the neighborhood boogeyman, Old Man Marley. It's Christmas Eve, and Kevin has wandered into a nearly empty church sanctuary. And a few people are scattered in the pews as a choir rehearses up front, and one of those people is none other than Old Man Marley. And he approaches Kevin, he asks if he can sit down, and the two, they have a pretty profound conversation about family and regret and fear. Now, I have to admit, I have some issues with the scene. Like, namely, why doesn't Old Man Marley stop and say, "Hey, Kevin, are you here alone? And where are your parents? And maybe we should call someone," right? Seems like a logical thing to do, but I've learned not to look too deeply for logic in Christmas movies from the early 90s. But Old Man Marley doesn't say any of that. Instead, he opens up to Kevin, and he shares. He shares his longing to spend time with his granddaughter. He shares his regrets about being estranged from his grown son. He shares his fear that any attempts to reconcile might be met with rejection. And that's when Kevin, in all of his 8-year-old wisdom, responds by saying, "You should call your son." And when Old Man Marley says, "But what if he won't talk to me?" Kevin responds by saying, "At least you'll know, and then you won't have to be afraid anymore." Might as well be an angel appearing to Old Man Marley in a dream, saying, "Do not be afraid. Do not let your fear stop you from reaching out. Do not be afraid," the angel says to Joseph, and perhaps to us too. And that message isn't so much about the fear that we feel as it is about how we react and respond to the fear we feel. It's what we heard in the meditation that Ben read for us this morning, right? When surfer Bethany Hamilton survived a shark attack to live, and more importantly, to surf another day, people asked her if she felt afraid to go back in the water, and she said, "Courage doesn't mean you don't get afraid. Courage means you don't let fear stop you. Do not be afraid. Do not let your fear stop you. Do not be afraid. Do not let your fear stop you," Bethany said to her incredulous fans. "And do not be afraid. Do not let your fear stop you," Kevin said to Old Man Marley. "Do not be afraid. Do not let your fear stop you," the angel said to Joseph in a dream. "And do not be afraid. Do not let your fear stop you," the angels keep on saying to us. In this Advent season, as you hear that angelic chorus of "do not be afraid," may you recognize whatever it is in this life that God is calling you to, whatever it is that you're so afraid of. May you acknowledge how fear may stop you from doing what God wants you to do and living as God intends for you to live. And knowing that God has given you a spirit not of fear, but of power, love, and self-control, may you make a conscious decision this very Advent to do something a little scary good. Will you pray with me? Gracious God, in this Advent season, we hear the angels. We hear them saying over and over, "Do not be afraid. need. We hear them saying it to Joseph this morning, saying, do not be afraid. Do not let your fear stop you. Or at times, we, like Joseph, allow our fear to stop us. We allow our fear to stop us from doing what is good and right, from doing what we were intending to do, from doing the things that you have called us to do, and from living the lives that you have intended for us to live. So help us, Lord. Help us, in the midst of our fear, to respond with action. Help us to step up and speak out. Help us to share and reach out. Help us to live as you have called us to live. Help us, Lord, live into the angel's words, and help us not to be afraid. In your name we pray. Amen. Amen.